Do you find yourself exhausted from constantly shuttling between your designer and your code, all in an effort to fine-tune your app and achieve that elusive pixel-perfect alignment with the design? Introducing Design Overlay. This revolutionary feature seamlessly bridges the gap between design and development, making it effortless to achieve pixel-perfect precision in your app layouts. With Design Overlay, designers and developers can easily compare wireframes to code layouts in real time, ensuring that the final product matches the initial vision with unparalleled accuracy. Say goodbye to the frustrating back and forth adjustments. Design Overlay empowers you to create visually stunning polished apps while streamlining the collaborative process with your designer like never before. I'm going to launch SWIFTUI Camp in a few weeks, so make sure to check out rebeloper.com/SWIFTUI-camp if you want to master SWIFTUI in 4 weeks. And seats are limited. There are a lot of people taking a look at SWIFTUI Camp. So I made a quick test that you can take before you may be allowed to join SWIFTUI Camp. So make sure to check it out, rebeloper.com/SWIFTUI-camp. Click the link, test the new SWIFTUI Mastery Test, and hopefully I will see you inside the SWIFTUI Camp. Now, today's topic is from design to code in a pixel-perfect way. This is what we are going to exactly do today. So what I have here is, I just have a project that I've been working on. Okay, this is just fictional, of course, but this is, let's say, the current state of my project. See, I have added quite a few lines of code right over here, and this is my design. It's on the iPhone 15 Pro, but my designer said, okay, that's fine, but this is actually what we want. This was actually the design that I was following along, and as it looks like we have a few issues right over here. For example, this image is not going all the way up. We have some corner radius issues, and also some, it's not pixel perfect. So what I have done is created a tool. You can find the link in the description if you want to make a purchase. It's just $10, so it's super dirty cheap. It's going to save you and your designers a ton of time. So here we have our design. Here is our current state of the code. Now, how can we use this new tool? Now, the tool that we are talking about, it's called Design Overlay. And once you do make your purchase, again, it's just $10, two cups of coffee or three cups of coffee, it's dirty cheap. So what you want to do, actually, it's one of my cheapest products, actually. So what you want to do is just drag and drop these two files into your project. Okay, let's click on finish right over there. And then what you want to do is add your actual design into the assets folder. So let's do that. That's our second step. Let me just move that over there. Okay, so here is our designed desired design. So currently this is what we got right over here, but we want that image to be displayed kind of overlaid over here, and let's just add it with an overlay. And you see we have design and design opacity. So let's just go with the most complicated one, with the design and design opacity. Now for the design, I'm going to grab this image's name. So let's copy that out and let's go back. Let's have some more space over here and just paste it over there. Now for the opacity, I'm going to add in here 1.0, and you will see in just a second what that does. So here is my original code as it is currently. We have some scroll views over here, and you can also scroll all the way up, by the way, just so you know, this is how it looks like. So what you see here is a kind of a new button, and let's see what it does. So what it does actually is just overlaying the desired design, which is really nice. And as you can see, we already have some major issues right over here that we are going to fix in just a second. So once I release this button, it's just going to fade away just like that, really nice. So again, we can just take a look at the design. Also, you can just take a look at pixel perfectly how you can do that. So that's what we are going to do today. Now, we have this as a 1% opacity. Okay, that's fine, but sometimes I want to have less opacity so I can see it overlaid. So let's just use 0.3 maybe. Again, the button is right over here, and now you can see that the opacity is not that much. Again, you can just tweak the opacity. I like to use the same, like the default one. I believe it's 0.7, so this is how you would do it. Okay, so let's tweak this. Okay, and again, this works in simulator on your device. And once it gets to the App Store, you don't even have to remove this one line of code because it's not going to show. It's only in debug mode. Okay, so, and yeah, that means not even in test flight. Okay, now what we want to do first is fix this issue with the alignment on the top. So let's have ignores safe area, and that should just move it all the way up. Now we have now a much better way. You see, now the top image of the Netflix is right over there, so it's really, really nice. Okay, so what's up next? I can see that on we have top 10 shows right now, and then we have top 5 shows. And by the way, it's really nice that we can just move this also vertically, this button, so we can get out of the way. So top 5 shows is what I need. We have top 10 shows, so let's change that. It's right over there, top 5 shows. Okay, let's see, now it's overing it really, really nicely. Next up, I can already see that we have some issues with the frame, with this frame. I believe, let's see, it's right over here, it's ending right over here on the cell, and it's ending kind of like over here on the design. Therefore, let's have this 300 set to 260. Let's see how it does right now. Now it's perfect. You see, it's just what we didn't even have to do anything. It's just like that. Okay, so what's up next? Well, I can already see the editor's pick. So what we want to have here is make it slightly smaller, the font size in the editor's pick. Okay, what I want to do is just go on the editor's picks. I can see that it's large title. Let's just see if title will do better. Okay, indeed, that is it. So finally, I can see, I don't know if you can notice it, but the corner radius for these lower images are much larger on the design than what we have in code. So what we want to do is search for that corner radius. Here it is. Instead of 2, what we have currently, just set it to 12. And now we are picture perfect. Of course, on the top you can see the time and the Wi-Fi and our charger over there. But yeah, that's fine. You don't need to care about that. And that it is. Make sure to check the link down in the description to get design overlay. It's as simple as that. Of course, you may add many, many other designs and just choose the design what you want to check against. And yeah, make sure also to check out rebeloper.com/SwiftUI-camp and take the SwiftUI mastery test. Now, if you want to know how you can test your apps through external testers or also with internal testers, make sure to check out this video right over here about test flight.